Chapter 4, It Only Gets Better From Here. My lean journey was really taking hold of me. It was exhilarating going through the process of transformation. With each suggestion for improvement, I would go through stages of disbelief and doubt, then humble resignation, only to be rewarded in complete and utter surprise as a simpler, more effective, and less costly result unveiled itself before my eyes. Since then, my critical eye has developed so that the waste component in everything we do at Fastcap just leaps out at me. Even though I have been doing lean for 10 years and people travel from around the world to see and understand our lean culture, I believe that 90% of everything I do and you do is waste. Here are the 8 wastes that plague us all. Number 8 is the greatest offender. Number 1, overproduction. That's what we were doing with the Laser Jam and Fastcap product. Number 2, overprocessing. That's kind of when you do something or you create another process to cover up a process that came before it because it really wasn't done very well. So instead of focusing on the real problem, you just create another process to cover up an existing one. A good example is a good friend of mine, that would be Greg, the guy recording this right now. When you go up to his bathroom, he's got a nice little sticker, very good visual control, on his toilet that says, hold for 3 seconds. Well, that's very good because strong visual controls and you know to hold the toilet for 3 seconds so it flushes right. But the reality of it is, the real problem is the flapper needs to be replaced. So if you replace the flapper, you don't have to hold the toilet for 3 seconds. So that's an example of overprocessing. Greg's laughing at me right now. He didn't even know I was going to say that. The next one, number 3, excess inventory. You overprocess, then you have a ton of inventory and you got to manage that. Number 4, defects. You make big batch work, you have defects in there, and then you got to go back and fix them all. Not a good thing. Transportation. You got to move all those defected parts. You got to store them. You got to move all that inventory. Not a good thing. Wasted motion. Lots of wasted motion in transportation in processes because people don't really analyze where the value or non-value added activity is. The only time you're adding value to something is when you're actually physically changing it. If I'm walking from point A to point B, I'm not changing the product. That's wasted motion. And then 7, waiting. Everywhere I go, I see people waiting. You know, the best example is the construction worker leaning on the shovel. You know what I mean? And number 8, the biggest one of all, unused employee genius. You see, locked up inside of all your employees and all your team members is incredible potential to solve problems. Now, most people don't even think they have this capacity. A matter of fact, when you start to tell them that they do, they look at you like, I don't know how to do that. But as you create a lean culture, you start to create problem solvers. And those problem solvers get real energized when they start finding out they have the capacity to solve problems. Okay, I went off script. Let's keep going. So we're in chapter 4, the last time I checked, and I'm just like ranting and raving here because I love what I'm talking about. Okay, finding the waste component is not a burden. It's a game, a giant scavenger hunt. I'm going off script again already. John Lucier, our general manager, came up with this one. It's a giant scavenger hunt. See, for us at Fastcap, lean is fun. It is not a burden. It's not something we have to do. It's a big game. And we treat it as such. And as a result, we get a pretty awesome result. So lean does not make things more difficult. Lean is focused on intentionally simplifying any process. When you make a process simpler, you yield a better and more satisfying result with less effort. That point cannot be overemphasized. Lean is not about working harder and more frantically, as is often thought. Oh, you're going to create a lean culture where everyone's going to work like a maniac? Just the opposite. But it's about making things simpler. It is not just about making everything faster, but about improving the quality of everything you do. It's rarely a huge or drastic change, but small baby steps in an endless drive to continuously improve everything. Remember What About Bob? That was my favorite movie. Baby steps. Remember, baby steps. Every day. Big changes are great, but it is not what lean is all about. I just shared how lean was introduced to my business model and how it yielded dramatic results. The implications for how this thinking can affect one's personal life is nothing short of amazing. If I haven't said it already, I'll keep saying it. Lean is about eliminating waste, about continuous improvement by approaching everything you do with an eye towards making things simpler. If it takes an hour to do something, ask yourself, can this be done in 30 minutes? It is not a frantic 30 minutes. It's 30 minutes you achieve by eliminating the 8 kinds of waste. Then, when you get it down to 30 minutes, you ask yourself, how can I get it down to 15 minutes? And after you've reduced it to 15 minutes, then you ask yourself, how can I get it to 7 minutes? Get ready to do a happy dance. Before long, you will have eliminated the process altogether. Sure, jubilation will set in. Lean is the art of subtraction, not addition. And I'm going to go off script here. People are wired to add to everything they do. As human beings, we like to add. But the art of lean is subtracting. And that cannot be emphasized enough. Lean is about continually improving the waste stream that's involved in everything you do in your life. How you make your lunch in the morning, how you get dressed in the morning. It can simplify how you collect your car keys and briefcase before you go to work. How you get the kids ready in the morning for family meal times, yard work, home maintenance. It doesn't matter. Lean thinking applies to every aspect of life and therefore can improve every aspect of life. Becoming a lean thinker makes everything in life a little bit better. Everything in life is a process. When you begin to learn how to think lean, you start incorporating certain questions into your daily thoughts. You will start to imagine how you can make those processes faster, safer, and simpler, and improve the quality of everything you do every day. Not once, not twice, but every day you will make small improvements for the rest of your life. That's what we mean by increasing the quality of your life, your business, and your general outlook on life. Can you imagine every day everything getting a little bit better? Not dramatically, but continuously getting better. When you become a lean thinker, this is what happens, and it is a massively fulfilling way to live. The one thing, finding the waste component is not a burden. It's a game. A giant scavenger hunt. A great video to look at to understand this one is Lean Kitchen. I just shot this recently, just at the completion of the book, because everybody always comes to our facility and looks at our kitchen at Fastcap and they're like, wow, this is pretty cool. Well, I never made a video of it, and now we've got one. It's only about 4 minutes long. I think you're gonna love it.